Hi friends, in this video I'm back with a new full tutorial of VphoneGaGa. So in this video we will learn how we can install Magisk Manager, all the required modules and its full functionality in this one complete video. So do not skip the video so you can understand it completely. So let's start. After installing Magisk Manager, here you can see all the functionality in the physical phone, like VphoneGaGa's Play Store, Magisk Manager root, and Android 10 supported, and other features are available in this virtual VphoneGaGa. So if we want to install the functionality like Vulkan Magisk Manager, and you can also change the ROM options to Android 10 or Android 7, which is required for you. And you can use any of the functionality that's available inside this because it's a VF version. So let's just install Magisk Manager and let me show you how it works and how you can install. Here are the tips how we can install Magisk Manager inside VphoneGaGa. So let's just click on enable Magisk and click restart later, and now go back, open root option and enable this root button, because we need to set up our Magisk Manager. So we need a root option that is called super user. So super user is now enabled. Here you can see, after we need to import our Magisk Manager from the files we have downloaded. So let's click on this transfer button, and now you have to click on this import button. Now if you have installed inside your physical phone, just click on the files and directory and where the folder it has been saved. So I have saved in the normal folder. So let's just import this and let's just find it. Here you can see Magisk Manager 2.5.1 is here. So I have to install this. Just click on it and it will automatically install inside the virtual machine. So it's success. Now let's get back, and further we need a process to activate this. So it's not showing but not activated till yet. For activated we need some further process. Here you can see it's showing NA, I mean not installed. So to install this, click on the install button and allow the permission, and now click on direct install recommended, and now click on let's go. So it will fetch all the files that are required to install Magisk Manager inside VphoneGaGa. When all the files have been fetched and all the done, then you have to restart this. To reboot this, click on the reboot button. If it's taking too much time, you can make a shortcut. Just click on the floating icon and click on turn off. And once turn off, now open again, and it will save the changes that we made. But in this case, it's not till be activated because it's will be in the abnormal state, as we have already another option of root that is called super user. So we have to disable the super user first. Now go again into the settings and click on root and disable this root option. So it's just for the super user. If you need the Magisk Manager, you have to disable this so Magisk Manager would work perfectly. And now let's check out if Magisk is activated right or not. So here you can see our Magisk Manager have been installed successfully, and it's now working. So further we need to check it's working or not, and you can install Magisk super user or modules. Before that, you can just go into the settings. Let me just make another thing, and let's first install the root checker to confirm it's working not. And here you can see this is purple showing. You can use your VPN inside VphoneGaGa, but you have to connect it outside your phone, and then the access of VPN will be available inside VphoneGaGa. So it's just simple. And let me just sign up my account in the Play Store of VphoneGaGa so we can install root checker and other apps. Wait a little while it's being installed. Sorry, sign up. So it's now just a sign. And now let's try if you can need to install FreeFire inside VphoneGaGa. It's available here. You can direct install or you can import from your local phone. But in case, in some case, your local phone imported FreeFire would not work because these both system has different features and different capabilities. So it's better to install from the Magisk manager inside VphoneGaGa. So you can also install PUBG if in some case PUBG get crashed. So you can import from your local device or you can install from it. And it works with PUBG Lite, and in the case of the original. So we have just installed the root checker, and let's check out if it's working or not. So let's open this and click on agree, click on get started. Now click on verify root. So you have to grant permissions of root to access the root by phone directory. So you can see after refreshing, it's showing us you congratulations, your root is successfully installed. So it means our Magisk manager working perfectly and it's activated. Further, if we need the Magisk modules, we can install it from the settings. To install the Magisk module, you need to click on install from storage, and in this here nothing is showing, and click on three dots in the and show the external storage, but till there is nothing. So we have, because we have not just imported the required zips of modules to install the to import these in the same manner we imported from our files and directory. Just click on the folder where all the messages has been saved. So in this video, I have shared with you 7 top Magisk modules that is very helpful and very recommended. So just I will check all the Magisk modules to install it. Once all the have been imported, we can install it one by one. So these all were successful. Let's go back. And in the same process, click on install from storage. Now click on three dots in the top corner, and it's showing hide internet storage. Click on hide internet storage, will show in the left corner, and you can see it's showing Nexus or storage. Now here you can see all the folders is showing, and in document folder you can see our imported all the Magisk module have been saved here. So we can install it in one by one. First of all, just click on the zip file and it will fetch all the files to install that module. So it's, when it's done, you have to reboot it to save the changes and to activate this. Let's do it. And if it's stuck, you can just restart the VphoneGaGa so it will save the changes. And let's check out if our imported and installed Magisk module is working or not. Here you can check, but there is still a error inside this, and here you can see module suspended because Zygisk is not enabled. To enable Zygisk, click on the Magisk setting and scroll down. Here you can see there is a Zygisk option and there is an enable option. Just enable this, and also enable enforce denial list to add the apps in the denial list. Let's just enable this, and then now you can see there are the apps that we can add in the denial list to hide from the root. And just now just reboot your phone to save all the changes. In this way, we can install all the Magisk manager, but not worry, I will show you practical step-by-step guide and their functionality, how these Magisk module works, and what the purpose of these Magisk modules. So here you can see we have just installed and activated Shaminko. Its X name is Zygisk. Okay, then let's check out in the settings, and you can see if we open in the configure denial list, it will show us the app that are using root. So we can just check it, and it will hide the root access from the app that is checked. So let's check out, as we previously checked, root was successfully working, But now when we hide it root from this root checker, it's not showing root. And again, we will test it with unchecking and refreshing it. So just close it and open again. And here you can check now, as you think, it's very perfectly working. So let's check out in the Play Store. And if you want any app that is not compatible with root access and it's giving an error, you can just use this Zygisk option and you can use any app that is not compatible with root. In for example, I will show these both apps that are used for online transactions, and these both are app do not need a root access. Also, it's not compatible with root access, so it will give error if we use these both apps with root access. So it's just example how you can use any app that is not compatible with root access. So click on the settings again. When the app is installed that is not compatible with root access, you have to add it in the hide list, I mean configure deny list. So open this option and check the both all the files that you need to hide root from, then restart your phone. So once your phone has been restarted, you can open the app and check if this is still giving error. And here you can see there is nothing error in this app, and it's perfectly working, and you can use the same manner any app that is not compatible with root access. So it's very working perfectly. There is nothing in the error. So in this way we can use any app. We will take another example of this app. This is another company, and it has also the same process. It gives mirror when you use the root of the rooted phone with this app. So but here you can see we can use this without any error, and it's also perfect working. So this is a problem is solved in the way you are using any app that has a not compatibility with root access, especially you are using a rooted device. So it just saved your time, and it's now perfect. We will further process and after confirm this option. So further, I have a gaming plugin that is called GG Game Guardian, and it's for the gamers who need to modify their games. And in some cases, we cannot use this in our local phone because it has many disadvantages also. So let's check out, and I have imported this in the files and in the same process where we saved all the Magisk modules. The Game Guardian is also available in the same directory. Let's install this. By the way, this is an app, not in a module, so you can just install it directly. And once it's installed, here you can see its option is icon is showing here. And let's process with it. And it's just a build for an older version. You can update any newer version. So as you can see on the app version, and everything is showing you. Just I'm showing it to you for educational purpose. You can use it on your own risk. It's just an app modifier app plugin that is used for games. So it's working perfectly. Further, we will process with our other apps and other logins. So let's go get back. And after we have confirmed these apps, now we will go further to the our other Magisk modules. To install other Magisk modules, we will continue the same process we have previously told you. So let's click on again install from storage, and it will redirect you the app to the zip files where our SPs have been saved. So its name is Lspeed signed. It means when you use a game, it will help you to operate with Lspeed options. So further you can explore this by yourself. In this video I'm just going to show you how you can install and explore these Magisk modules, and this is complete video, so hopefully this will help you, and it will be a very nice tutorial for you to understand the compatibility and usage of Magisk Manager, one of the best virtual Android. So in this way I will show you how LSPosed works, and LSPosed, so sorry there is an error because it failed. We need to install another module first, that is called Riru. So this is the module that should be installed before we install LSPosed, because LSPosed would not support our phone without installing this. So in this process, every time you install any Magisk or Zygisk module, you have to restore the app, so it will save the changes, and you have to again install another one that you want to install. The process is a little slower, but it will help you to use any of the app. Further, it gives us an error, so we need to disable Zygisk to make this working. So as you can see, we just disabled, and we can now install LSPosed. Now let's just install LSPosed, and basically LSPosed is an alternate of XPosed installer, in which there are thousands of available tools for gaming for your compatibility of phones, and this is best for any phone that is used with root access. So LSPosed installed also, and now it is working. After we restore the app, now we can further install other apps, other modules that we just trying to install. And here you can see now, but Shaminko is not working, and these both are working perfectly and enabled. So if you enable Zygisk, these apps like LSPosed and Riru will not work anymore. So Buxybox, this is one of the best plugin for Magisk Managers, and you can explore with your own requirements. And to install this, this is very simple, as just click on the zip file and it will install inside Magisk Manager. And in the same manner, we have to reboot the app, phone to install, to make it working and useful. So let's do it. So our next plugin is GPUTurboBoost. This is the app that helps you turbo boost your CPU of your phone. So it will help the best to install any game that is that need some higher resolutions and some higher compatibility to run better. In the same aspect, we will use a module that is called LSPosed. It's also used for gaming and enhance the performance of gaming. So this is the module that is used for most of gaming modification. And further, here you can check LSPosed, and all the modules we have installed are now available here. And you can check it's now installed perfectly. For further assignment, you can contact me, or you have any query, you can comment in the below, and I will help you to understand how this all process works. And if you have any question, you can ask me on my Telegram channel, or you can comment in the below section. Hopefully this video was helpful for you.